Hey guys, today I'm going to review for you my reference level headphone amplifier. This is the Lehman Audio Black Cube Linear. I call this reference level because it is, in my opinion, beyond what I call audiophile grade. Reference level means that I use this amplifier to compare, as a reference, to compare headphones and other headphones amplifier. So to me, it's that good. Now I want to show you guys this amplifier because I think that if you get an opportunity, you should definitely listen to it or check it out. This amplifier retails for $1,149 in the US. It's $1,149, but I know it's expensive, but I think that you will find that it's worth every penny once you listen to it. It is all aluminum housing. It's very heavy. It's about 3.3 pounds, so it's not light for headphones amplifier. It uses APS volume control, ALPS. It's actually the best volume control you can buy on the market. It's very smooth. There's no clicks to turn it on or off. It's a very smooth knob. It has two headphones outputs for you to compare headphones. It has one audio input. You can see on the back here the label in and out, and then an output for a amplifier, so you can use this guy as a pre-amplifier. It's got a power switch and then the IEC power cable. It has gain controls, so if you have headphones that are very inefficient, you can select the gains from 0 dB, which is a flat, no additional gain, and then you have 10 dB plus 10 dB and plus 20 dB. The headphones out has features on it, and this side right here on to the left, when you connect the headphones output, it will mute the line out from the back, but this side doesn't do that. So this side, if you want to use it as a preamp and headphones together, plug your headphones on to the right side, and both outputs will be active. It is made in Germany, so it's not a cheaply made product for the price that you're paying. Now, it is important to know that there are counterfeits out there that look similar to this. Of course, it's not the same name. They call it, I believe, it's Lovely Cube. Since this is the Black Cube Linear, so they call that the counterfeit, the Lovely Cube. There's also a M Stage, I believe, that you can buy on eBay. Those are said to have the same internals or same internals design. I'm not a audio engineer or designer, so I don't know if it's actually the same parts, but from the looks of it, it actually looks the same. But for me, I like to buy the genuine item. So, but you know, for the counterfeit, if you don't want to spend the $1,149 for this guy, the counterfeits are only about $200 or slightly over $200. I don't endorse counterfeits, so I don't think you should go out and buy one. But for the sake of interest, you can go out and take a look. Now, what I like so much about this amplifier is that it is very neutral. It does not add any color to the sound, and it's got a lot of power. The amplifier itself puts out 200 milliwatts at 300 ohms. 300 ohms is actually very high impedance. The Sennheiser XT800 is a 300 ohms headphone, so it's relatively hard to drive. This guy puts out 200 milliwatts to that the headphones, so it's very powerful. Now, at a lower impedance headphone, like one of the Sony headphones or the the Audio-Technica headphones that are low impedance. This guy at 600 ohms, I mean at 60 ohms, it puts out 400 milliwatts, so it doubles the power for an efficient amplifier, headphones at 60 ohms. What does that all mean? Just to give you a perspective, your average preamplifier, home preamplifier or CD player headphones output puts out about 25 milliwatts. So this guy puts out between 200 to 400 milliwatts. So it's a lot of current, a lot of juice. And so you'll be able to drive your headphones without any issues, and to its potential, really. For me, this headphone amplifier is truly the reference level. Now, I use it to compare headphones for you guys. It has two headphones outputs so that you can compare two different headphones together, and you can listen to them side by side and drive it off of a adequate amplifier. So that I like that a lot. It does come in a silver finish if you like silver over black. There are two additional models. This is the entry level, which is the simple, just pure amplifier. There's also one with the USB DAC inside. That one retails for a little bit more, and then there's also a special edition version with higher grade internal parts. I haven't tried any of the other ones. I hope to try those out in the near future. So I'll report back if I do. I think that for $1,149, this amplifier is a fantastic amplifier. It's definitely one to keep. And if you are looking for a reference level amplifier for your headphones, one that would give you the best sound quality, that would bring out the good and the bad of your headphones, this amplifier is truly the winner. And I think that if you get a chance to audition it, definitely do so. And if you can afford it, I'd go out and buy one. It's that good. So this is my quick review of the Lehman Audio Black Cube Lanier headphones amplifier. And I think that you should definitely at least audition it, if not buy it. Hope you guys like this review. I hope to bring you guys more hi-fi gear and headphones. Please subscribe. I am trying to reach out to manufacturers to bring me some products for this channel, so I can show you guys and do reviews on. So the more subscribers I have, the better chance that I'll get anything. So please subscribe, tell your friends, link my videos to your social networks, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye bye.